we're delighted to have the camera here tonight and to be filming and for future reference what happens at Easter. This is the meeting convened, the last meeting before the Easter commemoration of the National Graves Association. And at this meeting what we intend to do is to sort of go over all the areas and make sure we've got all the places covered for the parade on Sunday. The parade's very, very important to us, and in fact that's the highlight of our year. Besides the mundane day-to-day work that we do all year, it's great that the climax in Easter Sunday, and to see the people out on the street and the pageantry and the educational makeup of the parade, and hopefully it'll come together. The weather's good, and I'm hoping it'll continue. So we're going to open up the meeting tonight just with run over a few things that we've been doing. All the PR work on the parade has been done, and I think went over quite well. Loretta and Stephen and Jessie. At last, the big day's here as far as we're concerned. We have all arrangements made. Stuart and all are present. We have bands, everything on course. So what we're doing now, we're going down the address of Stuart's and make sure everybody knows what they're doing. So we're going to do that now.
And then after that?
After that, then we make our way down to the presentation in Culternon, where the dead volunteers' families will be made a presentation.
Hey folks, just got a wee bit of order, lads, just for a couple of minutes.
Thanks for coming, and this is a big day for us.
Not his day at all, it's my day.
Pat and tax. Well, first of all, thank you for coming, and it is a big day. Good weather, it's going to be a big crowd today. There's good will out there, and there's a good mood, so we're going to expect a full road. Couple of wee incidents last night and this morning, just wee daft things, which just remind you that there's a way in the background of all of this. There's a wee bit of silliness and a bit of madness going on. So we just need to be alert, not to overreact to anything, and to be there for all the reasons that we're there. We're here to honour our patriot dead. We're here to let our people have a good day, enjoy it in the most positive of circumstances. And our job through the structure and the organisation and the organisation of John and the general approach of the National Graves is to provide the safest and the best climate possible. That's what our goal is.
It's a presentation badge for the family of our deceased volunteers. It's a marking of the 30th anniversary of the hunger strike, and we decided that we'd present them. Being this year being so important, that that's what we'd use for our presentation. That's it, basically.
Apples still grow in November, and blossoms still bloom on each tree. When leaves they're still green in December, it's then that our land will be free. I wander her hills and her valleys, and still through my sorrow I see a land that has never known freedom.
Well, we have the families, at least some of the families here from Belfast. We have North, South and East Belfast, the areas where the IRA battalions were organised. We have families from the Fianna and families also from the Cumann na Mon. They're here for the presentation, and then we leave here and we go to Beachmount Avenue across the way, and that's to the Republican plaque, and there the commemoration will take place today.
Than to live in the cold chains of bondage, to bring back their rights were denied. Oh, where are you now?
Right, ladies and gentlemen, I can just have a wee bit of order just for 2 minutes. First of all, I'm sorry there for the delay, but there was roadblocks everywhere and I know we just had a problem getting here, and so did we. So we're going to start proceedings here. Most of you will see you and know your faces from last year and the year before, and thankfully it's been a very good occasion for all of us. We're, as a sort of prelude to the parade, so on behalf of the Belfast National Graves Association, I'd like to welcome you all here and thank you very much for coming. We have a busy day, as all of you have in front of you, and we've got a good day, thankfully. And we're going to move the parade on, hopefully not far from. And this is an important prelude to the parade, as I say. I haven't much to say other than to thank you for coming and welcome you. And we want to invite Bobby Storey to say a few words and give him better our main speaker. Thank you.
What joy is in eyes that can't see, when there's sorrow in sunshine and flowers, and still only our rivers run free. When all beside the vigil keep, the west asleep, the west asleep, a lost and where in thee. When Connacht lies in slumber deep, their lake and plain smile fair and free, mid rocks their guardian chivalry. Sing,
fabulous turnout on the road. Crowds are great.
On my shin sea, that chainless wave on lovely land, freedom and nationhood demand. Be sure the grave God never planned for slumbering slaves, a home so grand and long and brave and haughty rest, honored and sentinel. Quiet destroying their glory stress. For often in O'Connor's van to triumph diced each Connacht clan, and fleet is dear the Norman ran. And the Punam, the vigil key, the west to sleep, the west to sleep. Alas and well may are and we, that Connacht lies in slumber deep. But hark, a voice.